might be a chalk message this morning, not sure. It's something that started rolling over me here this week. And, just more want to talk about it. Title, I got a title of Light and Darkness. So, I'll talk about how the light will drive out darkness.
Amen.
You know, you come into this room, it'll be pitch black. You turn the light on, darkness flees. Amen?
Amen.
Go ahead and turn in your Bible. We're going to start out in Genesis chapter 1, verse 1. That's right at the beginning of the Bible there. Everybody already there will find that real easy. Father, I just praise you this morning for your goodness. I thank you, Father, that you know, we can think and we can go thinking and we can come up with a good word and all, but I mean, Lord, I just want to preach your word and I want to preach what you want to have preached. And so I just open myself up to you and let it just come out the way that you want it to come out, Lord. I have nothing to say of myself. It's all yours, your word. I give my tongue to you. I yield myself to you as a willing vessel, willing to be used by you, Father. Bring your word to your children. And I just thank you for it. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Says in verse 1 of Genesis chapter 1, in the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. Now the earth was formless and empty. Darkness was over the surface of the deep. And the Spirit of God was hovering over the waters. And I want to stop right there for a minute. And, even though there was darkness, the Spirit of God was still here.
Yeah.
Yes.
The Spirit of God was here before anything else was.
Yeah.
Before the light was.
Mm-hmm.
The Spirit of God was here. And then the Spirit of God said, let there be light, and there was light. Just like I said a while ago, you come into this room and you turn the light on and there's no more darkness. There's light here.
Amen.
You know, it drives out darkness.
Mm-hmm.
And so there was no darkness then. And God said, let there be light. And there was light. God saw that the light was good. And he separated the light from the darkness. God called the light day, and the darkness he called night. And there was evening, and there was morning, the first day. But the light and darkness that I'm wanting to talk about this morning is not necessarily the light that gives us illumination to be able to see things. I got to clean my glasses. Gives us illumination to be able to see things. Because what I'm wanting to talk about, the Bible says that Jesus is the light of the world.
Mm-hmm.
Amen?
Amen.
Yes.
That's what I'm wanting to talk about. Go in over to Matthew chapter 5 and verse 14. Verse 14 says, you are the light of the world. A city on a hill cannot be hid. Neither do people light a lamp and put it under a bowl. Instead, they put it on its stands, and it gives light to everyone in the house. In the same way, let your light shine before men, that they may see your good deeds and praise your Father in heaven. Matthew chapter 5, starting in verse 14. I'm going to read 14 through 16. I'm going to read that again. You are the light of the world. A city on a hill cannot be hid. Neither do people put a lamp light a lamp and put it under a bowl. Instead, they put it on its stand, and it gives light to everyone in the house. Now, how many of you know that right there is referring to the light that illuminates stuff, but it's using, it's referring to us as the light of the world.
Yes.
See? So, we are to drive out the darkness that's in the world.
Yes. Amen.
If we're the light of the world, we should be driving out the darkness that's in the world.
Yeah.
Amen?
Amen.
And as I pondered on this past week, you know, I mean, we got it lit up in here real bright right now. But you know, I can hit this switch here, and that brings lights down some, and that lights off over there, so all we got is lights here. And then I hit this switch, and it's a little more darker. But you see, you can still see. Why? Because it's in the daytime, you know. So the light is coming in through the windows, but if we covered up all the windows, pretty soon we could have it pitch black in here, you know. Just by shutting a little bit of light at a time, you can just continually
get
darker and darker and darker.
Amen.
And that's what I'm wanting to talk about this morning, is the light going out. Amen?
Yeah, amen.
You know, I wrote this, darkness can only take over light if the light is put out, turned out, or turned off. You see, darkness could not come in until I turned these lights out.
That's right.
The lights had to be turned out for the darkness to come in.
Yeah.
Now, there's darkness in this land. There's darkness in this world. But the Word says, you are the light of the world. Who is it referring to who is Jesus referring to when he said, you are the light of the world?
His disciples.
And who is that?
Us.
The church. The church is the light of the world.
Yeah.
In the last 50 or 60 years, we've been letting the light go dimmer and dimmer in this country.
Yeah.
You know, everybody they keep referring to, well, this country was founded on Christian morals, and it's the Christian nation, and it's true, it was. It still is. But, you know, when it started out, when they came from England over here, that's why they came, because they wanted to get out under the oppression, and they wanted to worship God their own way. And so they came here, and they formed a government. And they said, the government can't say how we can worship. We can worship our God the way we want to. You know? That's why America was founded. To be free to worship the God of the universe. To be free to worship God in any way we want to. And it's called freedom of religion. And not only can you worship God, but you can worship Buddha, you can worship whoever. It's a freedom of religion, you know. And so, down through the years, the church started out strong, and the light was strong, and everything, everybody was worshiping God, but darkness was still trying to come in. You see, darkness is still here. If we turn these lights off, darkness comes in.
Yep.
I mean, as soon as you turn the lights off, darkness rushes in.
Yeah.
Are you following my what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
See, the light came on 200 and something years ago, and this country was formed, and the government was formed, and we started, you know, we was free to worship God, and had godly morals, and people, you know, they just had godly ways, and it went across this land from sea to shining sea. People used to, I can remember in my childhood back in the 60s, you know, when you said you was a Christian, people had a little bit more respect for you. They had it meant something.
Yeah.
You know, if you said you was a pastor, they just put you a little bit further up because they recognized you as a man of God. Are you following me?
Yeah.
You know, the light was a lot brighter back then.
Yeah.
But the church was going to sleep. The church was being lulled to sleep. And the light, as they begin to get lulled to sleep, they begin to let the light go out. And they begin to let darkness come in. They begin to, you know, they begin to just like, and so to speak, turn the lights out. Down through the years, you know, we hear about Roe versus Wade, you know, and then we had that took prayer out of school and took the Bible out of school but you know, what's worse than that is the Bible and prayer came out of school, but if prayer would have stayed in the homes and if prayer would have and the Bible would have stayed in homes,
yeah.
The prayer would have stayed in school.
Yeah.
See, people think that was the problem. That's just where the darkness started coming in. Mm-hmm. But you see, it couldn't have came in if the church hadn't let the light go out.
Yeah.
It was burning bright. But instead of getting up and stoking fire, instead of getting up and turning the lamp back up, they just sit there in their dead chair and let the lamp continue to go out. No more prayer in school. Well, you see, when you put a lamp on a shelf somewhere or another, it'll burn for a while. And after a while, if you don't go and turn it up, or you may have to add some oil to it, depends on what type of fire you got, you know, or if you got a fire on a stick, you know, you may have to get another stick there to get the fire to going, you know, because the fire will burn out, and if the fire burns out, the flame goes out, and the flame is what makes the light. Amen. The church just let me read what I wrote here. What has happened? The church has, I'm getting ahead of myself there. The church just let the light go plumb out and just lulled themselves to sleep and forgot all about keeping the light out. And they let darkness come in.
Yeah.
And darkness just kept coming in. Things began to come into this land. They begin to let darkness take over. In the last 8 years, darkness has took over so much.
Yeah.
But one thing it did, it woke the church up.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
You see, that's what I've been pondering on last week about, you know, when Obama came in, the church was so asleep that they didn't even see Because if you would have been, if you would have been paying attention, I didn't have a problem. I didn't have one problem seeing that that man was no good for this country. From the time he began to come on the TV screen, there was something in me, which is called the Holy Ghost. I mean, every time I seen him on TV, I knew that man is not good. And not one time was I mesmerized by him. But this country was so mesmerized by him. Is that the right word?
Yeah.
They were so mesmerized by him. They were so taken by him. And I'm not talking about just heathen people. I'm talking about Christian people.
Yeah.
Christian people elected Barack Obama. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's right.
Good Christian people that were just lulled to sleep and had let the fire go completely out. They had let the fire go out in their heart. They walked the streets every day, and if you ask them, oh yeah, I'm a Christian. You know, that's just like there's a lot of people calls themselves Christians that are mad and upset because Hillary lost and they wanted Hillary to win. And they voted for Hillary. And they'll tell you they're a Christian. But how can you call yourself a Christian? And I say this. How can you call yourself a Christian and going to vote for somebody that wants to kill babies till the time they can come out the womb?
Amen.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
Yeah.
I say this, that you better check on your light.
Amen.
Amen.
Yes.
Because your light's getting dim.
Out.
Yeah.
Your light's getting dim.
Yes.
And it's about to go out, is all I can say.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. And I know none of y'all is like that, but somebody may see this.
Yep.
Amen.
You know? But what has happened is the church has woke up and turned on the light. And as we keep turning up the light more and more, darkness will flee.
Yeah, amen. That's it.
The church woke up.
Yeah,
yeah.
The church woke up. It woke up a little bit in 2012.
Yeah.
But there was still a lot of them still asleep. But this time, the church woke up.
Yeah.
And turned the lights on. And the roaches went scrambling. Amen?
Yeah. Right.
I mean, thank God. Because darkness was taking this country over. It was taking over, but you see, darkness cannot take over light.
That's right, it can't.
It never can.
That's right.
Darkness has no power over light. Think about that.
Yeah.
And see, darkness represents the devil.
Yeah.
And Jesus represents light.
Yeah.
Yes, amen.
He cannot take over. He tries to. He wants to try so bad to drown out the light of Jesus, but he can't.
That's right.
He can't.
Amen.
Because just like a while ago, I turned these lights off, darkness came in. So the minute you turn them back on, it goes.
Yep.
That's right.
And it's the same way. As if we will let our light shine, just like it says in Matthew, if we let our light shine, darkness will flee. The only time that darkness can take over is if light is turned out.
Yeah.
If we refuse to let our light shine. If we do like it says in Matthew 15, neither do people light a lamp and put it under a bowl. But you see, that's what the church was doing. The church had their lamp shining. They had it all included. You know, they brought it in these buildings, and they didn't ever want to let their light go out. But you see, the light is for the world.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
When we come in here, it's a time to trim our lamps.
Yeah.
Amen.
So that our lamps will be bright.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
It's good.
It's a time to restore our lamps with oil.
Yeah.
it's a time of being stoked up.
Yeah.
You understand what I'm talking about, being stoked up, you know?
Yeah.
You stoke the fire up. That brings me to my next point. Paul told Timothy over in 2 Timothy 1:6. He says, "For this reason I remind you to fan into flame the gift of God." That's what I wanted to bring out, is he said, fan into flame. See, you need to stir some versions say stir it up. The TCNT version, to stir into flame. The BER version says, to keep alive the flame of God. Keep alive the flame of God. And see what I said a while ago about the flame? The flame is what is the life. You know, last night we built the fire in the fireplace. And she's got a picture on Facebook, and you can see it, and that flame is just a roar. And it's a great big light in there. But when we went to bed, it was just smoldering. You could turn the lights out and it would have been dark in there. You could have just seen a red glow. That's all you would have seen. There was no light, right? Because the fire had went down. But as long as I kept stoking the fire,
yeah,
and kept stirring the fire, the flame would run. Are you hearing what I'm saying?
Yeah.
See, the church had went to sleep. They quit stirring the fire. They quit stoking the fire. And the fire was going out. I dare say that the fire was about out here, I think.
Yeah.
It was about out. But then, it began to get stirred. Thank God for Donald Trump. I believe he's going to do good for this country. But Donald Trump is nothing. The church don't pray and let the light shine.
Amen. Yeah,
Donald Trump cannot change this land. God will change
that's
this
right
land through
amen
Donald Trump.
Amen.
Yes. Donald Trump is just a man that God's going to use. I believe that Donald Trump is answered prayer to a church that got on their knees. And like 2 Chronicles
7:14.
If my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray and seek my face,
yep,
and turn from their wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven and will heal their land.
Yep.
See, God has heard our cry. He's heard the church's cry.
Yes.
The church woke up. Oh, goodness. We're about to let the fire go out. The fire was smoldering there. Man, at one time when they came from England, they had a blazing fire here. They had a bonfire. And down through the years, the church got lazy. Every now and then somebody would throw a wood or two on the fire. The flame kept going, but the longer it's gone, the longer it's gone, and the church has got lazier and lazier and sleepier and sleepier. Left their oil at the house. Lamps going out. Church is letting sin come in.
Yep.
Calling good evil and evil good. Church is doing that.
Yep.
Church is letting the world come in. You know, wanting to make it comfortable. You know, make it comfortable for them so the fleas and the roaches can come in. You know, maybe we can get them saved if we just do the things they do. No.
That's right.
That's not what it's about.
No.
Yes, God loves them where they're at. But at the same time, once He saves them, puts his spirit in them. He expects them to turn from their wicked ways. He expects them to make a 180. It's called repentance.
Amen.
If there's no repentance, there's no salvation.
Amen. Yeah, that's right.
I know people don't want to hear that, but that's the truth.
Yes.
If there's no repentance, if there's no turning from your wicked ways, there's no salvation. But Paul told Timothy to stir up the gift that was in him, stir it up to where it comes a flame. And see, that flame becomes the light. That's how we drive out the darkness.
Yeah.
But do y'all see what I'm talking about? For so long, from starting back in the 50s and 60s, the light started going out in this country. Mm-hmm. You know, the 40s, there was a healing revival in the early 1900s called the Azusa Street Revival. The healing broke out. Mm-hmm. You know, and then in the 40s, you know, there was healing and evangelism, and Billy Graham was popular in the 50s and 60s, you know, and in the 70s, and revival was going across the land. And starting in about the 60s, then darkness started coming in. Well, darkness can't come in if the light's not turned out. You see?
Yeah.
So the church started turning the light out, or the church started letting the light go out. Either one, turning it out or letting it go out. I think at first the church was just letting the light go out. And then, after a while, the church got comfortable in the dimness and they wanted it a little more darker. Yeah. And a little more darker. And a little more darker. No, it just feels good this way. The darkness was just all around them, just a little bit of light. Because we don't want too much of that light, because the bright light hurts our eyes. And what's it do? It shows up the sin.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Come on.
You know, you can go into a dimly lit room, and there could be dirt all over the walls, and on the fans and on the lights, but it's just real dim and dark, and you can't see all that. And you can, oh man, this is so beautiful. Such a lovely room. And then somebody turns the light on bright. Dirt all around. Dirt hanging on the wall, dirt hanging off the fan, dirt hanging off the pictures. But you see, you didn't see that because it was so dimly lit.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Are you hearing what I'm saying? Yeah. That's the way we was in this country. There was dirt hanging on the walls everywhere.
Yeah.
The light was getting so dim here that the sin was just everywhere. The church was just comfortable with it.
Yeah.
It's still comfortable with it. A lot of them are, but a lot of them are waking up.
Yeah.
Because the church is beginning to wake up. I think it's God's mercy giving us one more chance.
Yeah, I think
amen. Amen.
Everybody thought it was God's judgment with Obama and all, I think that he said he's heard our cry and he's going to give us another chance.
Yeah.
I also believe that. And I not only believe that, I know it, because I could be long suffering with my children, but then there would come a time when I would say, okay, that's it. Oh no, I'll change. Nope. It's too late. I've given you four chances. Now you're going to face this. You see?
Mm-hmm.
But people think, oh, God's a God of love. He is. He loves us.
Yeah.
I think his mercy is being shown right now. And And I think what it is okay, you have a chance. Now what the church's going to do?
Yeah.
It's not what this country going to do. It's what's the church going to do.
Amen, church.
Yes.
What's the church going to do with the opportunity that we have? Because there's going to be things that's going to be lifted. There's going to be opportunities there.
Yeah.
But the longest that Donald Trump can be in office is 8 years. Then who's coming in? And I mean, he's just got 4 and then he's got to run for re-election again. So in 4 years, what's going to happen? It's going to determine, these 4 years, it's going to determine what the church does in these next 4 years, whether Donald Trump will be in office in 2020.
Yeah.
It's not about what Donald Trump does, it's about what the church does.
Yeah, yeah.
Is the church going to lay back and go to sleep now? We've got a little wood on the fire and... Oh, man, let's... You say one thing about that fire in there. Katie, as long as I'm here, she gets to enjoy it. She sits there and watches TV. But I'll sit there and after a while it'll begin to die down and I get up and stir it a little bit and it'll puff back up. A fire's got to be stirred.
Yeah, it does.
If it's not stirred, it will go out.
Yeah.
Light. Our light, you know, we can't refer to these lights because, well, they'll eventually burn out. You know, like Aubrey had to change these bulbs the other day because they finally burn out. But, you know, before we had electricity, you had lamps and stuff, you know, and you can see over in Matthew chapter 25 about the 10 virgins. You know, the five wise, they took their lamps and they trimmed them and they had plenty of oil, and the five foolish didn't bring no oil with them. And so, their lamps, when it come time to go out to meet the bridegroom, their lamps were no good to them anymore. They had let their light go out.
Yeah.
The light went out, darkness was overtaking them, and they couldn't get to the bridegroom.
Yeah, yeah. Wow.
How bright's your light?
Yeah.
How much oil do you have to supply your lamp with for the flame? Because the bridegroom's coming.
Yeah, yeah.
And you gotta have your lamps trimmed and ready.
Amen.
Your light needs to be burning bright.
Amen.
Well, I figured this was going to be a kind of a short message this morning, but I really think it was an important message.
Amen.
Yes.
Good word.
And I know everybody here is on fire for God. I believe that. You know. But at the same time, you know, we do have the camera and we put the videos out there. Whether anybody watches them, I don't know, you know. You put the feed out there, if they want to eat it, they'll eat it. If they don't, all you can do is put the feed there for them.
That's right.
Amen?
Amen.
Yeah. Go ahead and stand on your feet.